Welcome back to the course on power quality by VTU eShikshana. I'm Dr. Prema, Associate Professor, BMS College of Engineering, Bangalore. So we are here with the module 4 of the course power quality, and the module 4 deals applied harmonics. This is the second lecture on module 4, and the topics on applied harmonics are harmonic distortion evaluation, harmonic control, where to control harmonics, harmonic studies, devices to control harmonics, filter design, case studies on filter design, and standards on harmonics. So in the lecture 1 of module 4, we have seen how to evaluate a harmonic distortion. So we also saw the limitations provided by IEEE standards for the harmonic distortion, the harmonic current injection from the end user side, and the harmonic voltage distortion from the utility side. So that is what we had seen on lecture 1. Today we are with this lecture 2 of module 4. The main learning objectives of today's lecture are to describe the methods of controlling harmonics, and to identify the methods like reducing the harmonic current by modifying load, by filtering, or by modifying the frequency response. And also we are going to learn to identify where to control the harmonics. So let's start with today's lecture. Here, first topic is principles of controlling harmonics. Now we all know that harmonic distortions are present in some degree or other in all power systems. It may be excessive or it may be very light. Fundamentally, we need to control the harmonics only when they become very serious, when they become a serious issue which affects the system responses. And there are three common causes for harmonic problems. The first one is the source of harmonic current is too great, either in some or other way, the harmonic current is very high. And the second cause is the path in which the current flow is too long, resulting in either a high voltage distortion or a telephonic interference. So this is the second cause of harmonic. And the third cause is the response of the system magnifies, or one or more harmonic to a degree greater than it can be tolerated. So yesterday's lecture, we have seen some tolerance limits for this harmonic current and harmonic voltage. Now, if in case of resonance, and if it magnifies one or more harmonic components, and if it is more than the tolerance limit, then we need to control the harmonic. Now, when we have a problem which needs to be controlled, the basic options for controlling are mainly three. The first one is to reduce the harmonic current produced by the load. So there are various ways to reduce the harmonic current. We will see in detail what are they. And the second method is to add filters to either pass the harmonic currents of the system, or to block the currents entering the system. That means you provide an alternate path for the current to flow so that you are completely blocking the current to enter the system. Or the third way is to supply harmonic current locally. So these are the three methods in the second one, which is by adding some extra device or adding a filter to control the harmonics. And we have another third method, which is to modify the frequency response of the system by adding line chokes, filters, or some inductances or capacitance, adding an extra component. We're going to change the frequency response of the system. So these are the three main methods by which we can control the harmonics in the system. Now, let us take each one in detail, each one separately. First, let us take the case when we are going to reduce the harmonic current produced by the load. Now, if you want to reduce the harmonic current, the only way is to modify the load, right? Otherwise, it is very difficult to reduce the harmonic current. Now, if you are talking about modifying the load, it is often impossible to modify the existing load just to satisfy the or to reduce the harmonic current. So the load equipment cannot be replaced, or the load equipment cannot be modified in most of the cases. In case of industrial loads, when we have a plant, just for reducing the harmonic current, it is not possible to modify the load. Then but there are some cases where we can do it indirectly. What are those methods? We can have some transformer connections to reduce the harmonic current in a three-phase system. So we have seen some methods earlier. So we can adopt any one of the methods to have a three-phase system. In case of three-phase system, we can change the harmonic connection. And also, if you are using a 12-pulse converter, if you in any plan, if you are having a 12-pulse converter, then it is often a one method which is followed. That is to shift. Suppose if you are using a 12-pulse converter, generally the 12-pulse converter will be installed by 2 6-pulse converters. So if you have 2 6-pulse converters, it is often advantageous if you introduce a phase shift between these 2 6-pulse converters. So this can dramatically reduce, or this can almost eliminate the 5th and 7th harmonic component in the system. So this can be employed if you have a 12-pulse converter in the system. This is one of the ways. And we also have some methods like to reduce the or to block the zero sequence current. You can use a delta connected transformer. So we know that in delta connected transformer, the zero sequence current doesn't flow out. It gets trapped in the system itself. So you can adopt a delta connected transformer to avoid the zero sequence current. And there are other methods like introducing a zigzag transformer and grounding transformer, which can shunt the tripling current. So these are some of the methods. In that, the first one is suppose you have a 12-pulse converter. So you can see the figure here. Here in the figure, we have a 12-pulse converter, which is made up of 2 6-pulse converters. So each of the converters are shown on top and bottom are each 6-pulse converters. Now what we have done is one 6-pulse converter is fed by a delta connected system and the other one is a star connected. This can introduce a phase shift of 30 degree between the outputs of these 2 6-pulse converters. And this can reduce the 5th and 7th harmonic component. So this is one very commonly used method in case of 12-pulse converter. Now, apart from that, we can have delta connector transformer to avoid the zero sequence current. Also, we can make use of zigzag transformers and grounding transformers. We are going to deal in detail what is a zigzag transformer and how the connections are done in a little more later session. We are only discussing what are the common methods of controlling the harmonics. The methods in detail will be dealt later. Okay. So this is the first method. This is basically to modify the load or to reduce the harmonic injection. So there are indirectly we are doing it. That if you want to do it directly, you will have to do some modification in the load, which is hardly a solution. So we can have indirect methods like introducing a delta connection transformer or you can have this phase shift, or even you can use some other transformers like zigzag transformer. So this is for the first method, which is by modifying the load or basically reducing the harmonic current. Now the second method is a very commonly used method. This is the filtering method. So what do we do here? You would have studied the filters. So there are passive and active filters available now. So we can make use of harmonic filters. You can have shunt harmonic filters and the series harmonic filters, and shunt is the most commonly used one. So what we do here, this shunt filter as shown in figure, we have a passive filter, which has passive elements like inductors and capacitors, and active filters, we have power electronic converters, which can be controlled automatically. So there are active and passive filters. So in case of passive filter, we have a shunt connection. You can either have I'll show you some configurations in the next slide. So generally what we do, these shunt filters are connected very near to the source so that these filters will provide a low impedance path for most of the harmonic currents, and the most of the harmonic currents will get bypassed to the filter. the current gets diverted and it flows to the filter, and we can filter out the harmonic current. So that is the basic principle of using a harmonic filter. And the, another advantage of shunt filters is that apart from having reducing the harmonic current, it can also provide the reactive power required. Most of the time, at the fundamental frequency, the reactive power required can be compensated using these shunt filter. And I will show some of the configurations of shunt filter. Here we can see using passive elements. So this is an example of passive shunt filter. So we can see a combination of resistance capacitance in the first case. Then we have RL parallel circuit in series with a capacitor. And then, so this is basically a different order. So we have first order, second order, third order filters here. Depending upon our requirement and what frequencies we need to eliminate, we can choose a filter. We will come back to the design of filter in detail a little late. So this is one method. And the third method is by modifying the system frequency response. So there are a number of methods to modify the adverse effects of harmonics. The first one is to add a shunt filter. As we told, discussed in the earlier case, we can add a shunt filter. When we add a shunt filter, you can eliminate the harmonic current just like we saw earlier. Not only it will eliminate the harmonic current by adding extra L and C components, it is actually modifying the frequency response. So we can treat this also as one of the methods. And then the second one is to add a reactor to detune the system. So what do you mean by detuning? We are tuning the system to a different frequency, off frequency level. That is the meaning of detuning. So here, the harmful resonances are generally okay. We know that we have seen in the last unit also that we have series and parallel resonance problems which occur due to harmonics. So the main reason is we have distortions in the current due to non-linearity, and when we have many frequency components, the system impedance and the capacitance, shunt capacitances in the system can create a resonance, right? So harmful resonance are generally occurring between the system inductance and the shunt. In such case, a reactor must be added between the capacitor and the supply system source. So one method is to simply put a reactor in series with the capacitor to move the system resonance without actually tuning the capacitor to create a filter. So here we are not tuning it, we are simply adding one reactor in series with the capacitor to detune the system. And another method is to add a reactance to the line of the system. So in both the ways, we are changing the resonant condition of the system so that we are detuning the system and we are avoiding the condition of resonance. So that is what happened in the second method, which is by adding a reactor to detune the system. Now the third method with which we can modify the frequency response is to change the size of the capacitor. So here also it is another way of doing detuning. Like instead of adding a reactor, here we are going to change the value of the capacitance. So we are going to change the capacitance of the system. This is often the least expensive options what we have here for both utilities and industrial customers. This is the least costly method, expensive method. And the fourth one is to move a capacitor to a point on the system where a different short circuit impedance or higher losses. So this is also an option for utilities when a new capacitor bank is causing some telephonic interference. So in such cases, in utility, suppose if you are introducing a new bank, a capacitor bank in some location, and if it is creating some telephonic interferences, then you can change the position of that band to little away so that you can avoid that interference. But this is only possible in the case of utility. In case of industrial loads, it is very difficult to move the capacitor bank to some other place because it doesn't serve the purpose of power factor correction or improving the power factor in industry. So mainly for in the utility, when you are doing the harmonic control in the utility system, this is one option to change the position of the capacitor bank. And the last option is to remove the capacitor and simply accept higher losses. So mainly we are having shunt capacitances to improve your power factor. So most of the industrial loads, depending upon their power factor, if the power factor is very low due to their plant, then they will have to pay a penalty to the utility. So to avoid that, we generally install shunt capacitance in the industrial areas. Now, if you want to avoid harmonics due to the shunt capacitance, one very crude way of doing is to remove the capacitor and simply accept the higher losses and pay the penalty. If technically feasible, this is occasionally the best economic choice because you are just removing the system and power factor correction equipment and you are bearing the losses occurred by that. This is very crude method. But technically, if it is technically feasible, that means if the harmonic if it is able to, by removing that, if it is able to help in the harmonic control, and if it is technically feasible, then it is the most economical way of doing it. So we will just have a recap of what we have seen here. Basically, we saw basically, we saw the method to control the harmonic. So there are mainly three methods to control harmonic. The first one is to change the load, do some modification on the load side so that we can reduce the harmonic currents in the load. So most of the time, it is not possible to modify the load as such, but there are some ways to do that just by adding some extra, by changing the connections of the transformer, or by taking some phase shift between the converters, or by selective elimination of harmonics, we say that. So by adapting some methods for selective elimination of harmonics, also to use zigzag capacitance. Those is the first method. And second method is to use some filter technique. So we have passive filters and we have active filters. Generally, this shunt capacitance, shunt filters will provide a low impedance path for a harmonic current to flow, so that we can eliminate the harmonics. And the third method is to modify the system response. There are many ways to modify. Either we can add a shunt filter or we can add a reactor to detune the system. That reactor can be either added to the capacitor bank or it can be added to the line directly. Or another way is to change the capacitor size, or we can also move the capacitor bank from one position to another to avoid condition of resonance. This is the possible in the case of utility. Also, another way is to remove the capacitor and accept the losses. That's the last and crude way. So these are the methods to control the harmonic. Now, a question arises, where exactly we have to control the harmonic? So either you can control the harmonics on the end user side, or you can control the harmonics in the utility side. So we have seen some methods to control, and where exactly to implement these methods. That is what we are going to see now. So there are again two ways to do this. Either we can do the controlling techniques on the distribution feeders, or we can do the controlling techniques on the end user side. Now, suppose if you are doing it on the utility side, distribution feeders, you can either do the modifications on the feeder capacitor bank, or you can do it on the distribution feeders. So let us take each case separately. Suppose in the case of feeder capacitor bank, some harmonics are associated with feeder capacitor bank, and they are mainly due to increase in the triplen harmonics in the neutral of the feeder. So because of the triplen harmonic, there are some problems which occurs on the feeder capacitor bank. Now, to change the flow of this triplen or a zero sequence harmonic current, what generally we can do is to change the neutral connection of the star connected capacitor bank. So these capacitor banks can be either connected in star or delta. So if you are changing the neutral of the star connected capacitance bank, you can eliminate or you can reduce the zero sequence current. Now, if the flow has to be completely blocked, you need to float the neutral so that the current, triplet harmonic current, will not flow through the neutral. We have seen that the problem of triplet harmonics is that the triplet harmonics are in phase with all the three phase currents, and all these currents will get added up and it flows through the neutral. Suppose if you want to block the triplet harmonic current, you can change the neutral connection. You can even make the phase, the neutral floating, so that the current will not flow through the neutral. So this is one case. In other cases, it is more advantageous to help the flow or to aid the flow by putting a reactor in the neutral and convert the bank into a tuned resonance filter. So if you are adding a reactance to the neutral, what happens? Again, you are tuning the system. So the tuning will be done for attracting the zero sequence harmonic. So the zero sequence harmonic will get, you are actually aiding the zero sequence harmonic to flow through the neutral. So these are two ways by which we can do the harmonic control on the feeder capacitor bank. Now the harmonic problems on distribution feeders often exist only on light load. So on light load, what happened? The voltage rises, and this will cause, because the load is light, the voltage rises, and this will cause the distribution transformers to produce more harmonic currents, and there will be what happens sometimes, as I was discussing in the previous cases, the resistances in the system or the load in the system actually dampens the harmonics in some cases. But under light load, what happens? There will be not be enough resistance to damp the resonance. So because of that, the harmonic components will shoot up. It will increase. So in such cases, one of the options is to switch the capacitors. Switch off the capacitors at the time. During light load, you switch off the capacitor bank so that the resonance doesn't happen. Otherwise, what happens? The resonance condition occurs under light load. The harmonic problems increase due to that. And also the third method is to filter the harmonic current on distribution feeders, is to distribute the filters on different points. So you add a filter and generally you distribute it to the different points, so that will shorten the average path of the harmonic current, and that can also reduce the telephonic interferences, and this will also reduce the voltage drop in the line. So what do we do generally? We will distribute the filters. Instead of connecting one filter, we distribute the filter at different points. So what happens? These filters will appear as a short circuit to at least one of the harmonic components, and this will keep the voltage distortion on the feeder to a minimum value. So this is these are the three methods by which we can control the harmonics on the utility feeders. So I will show you one figure, and here we can see that this is an overgrid distribution feeder, and we can see that there are reactors connected, and mainly this is oil insulated iron core reactors which are connected on separate poles from capacitor bank and filter. So here this is an example of distributed filters connected on the feeder side. So this is one method by which we can control the harmonics. Now if you want to control the harmonics at the end user, it is most cases it is easier to control the harmonics on the end user. Now, when harmonic problems arise in the end user facility, the first step is to determine if the main cause of resonance with the power factor capacitors, suppose you have to check whether you have capacitor bank, and is the main cause of harmonics because of the resonance between the capacitor bank and the system. So if it is so, if the resonance is the actual cause, then the first attempt and the simple solution will be to use a different capacitor size. So if you know that the capacitor is actually causing the problem, if the capacitor is causing a resonance, then the first step And the easy step is to change the capacitor size. And nowadays we have, instead of passive, you have automatic power factor controllers, APFCs, and which uses power electronic control. And this can automatically change the value of the capacitance. So that can be installed so that the capacitor size can be changed, so that you are avoiding the condition of resonance. So this is easier in the case of end user side than the utility side. Now with this kind of automatic power factor controllers, it should be possible to select a control scheme that will avoid a configuration which will inject the harmonics. So you can do the calculations and the control system can be designed so that it will avoid the condition of resonance. And in other cases, you can switch the capacitors at random with the load, so that you are avoiding, again, you are avoiding the condition of resonance, and it will be impossible to, sometimes what happens, it will be impossible to avoid the resonance completely. That time, we will have to go for filtering. Now, when you are installing the filters on the end users, low voltage side, it is generally more practical and economical than the utility distribution side. So it will be easier because the size of the filter will be lesser when you are using on the end user side. So when you are installing filters on the end user side, you are installing filters on different areas. So it will be easier to do that in the end user side than the utility system. And the criteria for the filter design also will be easily met if it is an end user side. And the filter equipment also will be readily available on the market if you are doing it on the end user side. Whereas it will be difficult in the case of utility system, because there in case of utility side, we have to calculate the entire harmonic effect due to all the end users. Whereas if you are using on the end user side, you will have to think of only that particular load and tune or design a filter according to the requirements. So requirements are also simple and the solution will also be readily available in the market. So it is always easier to have a filter on the end user side than connecting on the utility side. Now, when the magnitude of harmonic currents injected on the load is very high, then if it's an industrial load, the industrialist or the industrial users also should investigate the means of reducing harmonics by using a different transformer connection, like using a zigzag transformer or changing the connection from star to delta, or using some line chokes, adding some reactors. So all these possibilities can be tried by the industrial users to reduce the capacity. So whatever methods we have seen, we have discussed for the utility side, is also possible in the case of end user side, like changing the load parameters, changing the load, or by doing some modification on the load will be easier in the case of end user side. And similarly, if you want to change the frequency response, you can easily add some reactors, or you can easily add some designs on filters, so that you can completely detune the system or completely remove the resonant condition on the end user side. So depending upon where exactly the harmonic problem arises, we will have to decide whether to control the harmonics from the utility side or from the end user side. So this is the summary of the lecture 2 of module 4. And in the next class, we'll be discussing how to measure the harmonic, what are the different parameters and what are the different methods to measure the harmonic, and how exactly we are going to study a harmonic. So harmonic study is a very important topic, which we'll be covering in the third lecture. So we'll end the session today. Thank you.